John, thank you for that. See at the top of the hour, 15 minutes away. Now setting sail, an enormous salute to our country and our military and the lives lost on September 11th. Look at this beautiful ship here. This is the USS New York, named to honor those lost in the attacks of 9/11. The hull of the ship is forged from 7.5 tons of steel salvaged from the Twin Towers. The crest of the vessel features an image of the World Trade Center. With the Phoenix rising and the words "Never Forget," Chuck Nash is here to talk about, a retired U.S. Navy captain and Fox News military analyst. This is quite an honor, sir. Good morning to you. What does this mean in terms of symbolism? I guess, first of all, for the military that's carrying out this war on terror as we speak.
Well, good morning, Bill. If you look at the number of people, the surge in enlistments and the reenlistment rates since 9/11, 9/11 was an absolute turning point. It was a major incident in this country. We were under attack, and the people of the United States literally are willing to put their blood and treasure on the line. And so you've got the crew of this ship, the people down in the shipyards who stayed past their retirement dates to complete this ship. This is, the metaphors just absolutely abound. If you think about this for a second, the steel that was forged in fire that built the World Trade Center to start with has now been reborn truly as the leading edge of this ship, and the fire that forged that original steel, reforged that steel into this ship, is going to live on in the fire and the passion of those who continue to serve this country now and in the future in this ship.
It'll sail the world, right? I mean, it could be in harm's way.
Absolutely.
It could contribute to the current war on terror. And here's what I'm thinking. I know how the military looks at treasures like these. Mm-hmm. And when the USS New York shows up in the Persian Gulf or the Suez Canal or the Mediterranean or the west coast of California, it's like a celebrity coming into port.
Well, I'll tell you what, she's going to have a truly unique bond between our Navy and the city of New York and the state of New York, because she carries with her that name around the world. And as you point out, whether it's in a military contingency, whether it's in combat operations, or whether it is in, quite frankly, in humanitarian work, it is the name New York that'll be out there, either for people in despair because they're under oppression or because they just need basic help and food and medical care. This ship is going to carry that promise with her into the future.
It's considered an amphibious transport dock. What is that? Does that serve primarily the Marines or the Navy or both?
This ship has been purpose-built to embark a landing party, which is about 600 or almost 700 Marines, as well as their vertical lift capability, their helicopters. They've got landing craft that come in and out of the ship. From the keel up, this thing was designed for the purpose of putting combat Marines ashore.
Well, we salute all you today. Captain, thank you for coming in today. Good to see
Always
you.
Always a pleasure,
Bill. You got it. Our friends at Fox and Friends, by the way, they're going to be on board the USS New York next week, so make sure you check that out here on the Fox News Channel. Quite an honor.